Okay, fine. So today we are going to discuss the block diagram reduction problem. So now I am going to sketch the particular block diagram. So here we have signal R. It is connected to the summing operator with positive, then to the block G1, and then again to the summing operator. The symbol is positive, and then to the signal to the block G2. Then again to the summing operator with the positive command, and then it is connected to the block G3, and then it is sent to the output, which is CFS. And from there, here this one is R of S, right? And now from this CS we have feedback, loan feedback H1, right? So this is connected to this R under the negative command. That means you are going to deduct this symbol, this block. And then we have another block H2, again taken from the output, and that is connected to the summing operator after G2, which is at here. So what is the command? It's negative. Now, because you have to be very careful about the command, right? This signal and this signal, right? So the result which is coming from this side, right? When it comes here, so with that result, we are going to deduct this one. That means, in simple words, this signal minus this signal. Okay. And okay, so then again there is another signal which is taken from here, and then it is sent through this block H3, and it is connected to this summing operator under the negative command. So now this is our block diagram, and I hope this is clear, right? So let's check whether everything is clear. Yeah, so all are clear. Great. So now we are going to do the block diagram reduction. And guys, now just keep in mind, block diagram reduction is something like meditation like thing, right? Because don't think doing a lot of block diagram reduction problems will help you to do the block diagram, that particular problem in a final exam, right? Because the problem is, when you are solving this kind of a problem, you must perform the logic, right? Not the number of problems. Okay, so now let's see. There are a lot of reduction techniques we are going to use, but I will tell you the result where I am mostly interested in, right? This is a very famous result. There are many results, but I will teach you some basic results. Now think, here there is a signal X, okay? It is coming to the summing operator with the positive command. Then it is sent through block G, then it is sent through the final output, so let's call it Y. And now think, another reverse signal is taken called H, is again connected to the summing operator under the negative command. So now how you are going to reduce this, because you basically know that, like, this system we can further reduce to a system like this, right? That is the most important thing. Okay, this G and this H, be careful about this signal. So what is this? Negative. So the final result will be G divided by 1 plus G H, right? So this same thing we can represent in this format. Be very careful, this input must be positive and this feedback signal must be negative. So if it is like that, the result will be like this, right? So you can further prove this. I'll teach you how. Okay, so look at here, this signal Y, little by little it comes like this, then it has to jump over this block. So what is the result after that? Y times H. Okay, so Y times H comes up to here. Okay, so what is the result that is produced after here? From this side we get X, and from this side we get yh. So because of this negative, it must be minus yh. So that is the signal that is coming out from here. Then that signal has to jump this g. So what is the signal up to here? X minus yh. So I'll sketch it here. X minus yh, that's the signal. It has to jump from this g, then final result will be y. So now when you do the simplification for this, you can very clearly see, guys, x times g plus y times h, g equals y. Okay, this is negative. X times g minus y h g, because here negative, right? So here what you have is negative. So now you can keep x g here, and you can send y h g to other side. So y plus y h g. Okay, so x times g equals y times, you can do the factorization, 1 plus h g. So now it's very easily you can say, keep the y here, put this x to that side, so this x will come as the denominator. So you can obtain y over x. So what is y over x? G divided by 1 plus h g. So this is how this result comes, right? So now the fact is, like, many people know about this reduction rule, but they are not, like, they don't know how to use this. That's the problem, right? So knowing something and knowing about something are actually two different cases, right? So now this is the result, and you know how you're going to obtain that. So now let's see this famous block diagram reduction rule, that if you have something like this, now that's the reduction rule. If you have something like this, you can represent the same signal by this, right? So but knowing this is not enough. Now just see the differences. If you are going to reduce this kind of a system to this kind of a system, you can see what are the differences. No feedback. Now see, this part is feedback. Number one is no feedback. Okay, what is the next thing? See, here there is a summing operator, but here no summing operator. So the next thing is no summing operator. Okay, so it will be just a like direct signal. Okay, so now that's it. So now we'll focus on this thing. I'll get the red pen. Right, so now this is our target. We need to reduce this. Okay, so now focus. What shall we do? Fine. So now here you can see, now we are going to see how we can get the logics. Okay, right, just look at this part. Right, in here if we don't have a part like this, we can very easily reduce this kind of a thing into a simple direct format like this, right? Because unfortunately we have what you call a takeoff point, right? Or a signal that is going away. So if we can just change this position, right? So if we can keep a direct signal without this takeoff point, then it is very easy. We can easily reduce this. And so we are going to do something like this. So be very careful. Now, actually, guys, what I want to tell you is, say, now here you can see we have a takeoff point. That's clear, right? So now just think, we don't have such a kind of a signal, right? So then you can very easily see that it is very easy, right? Why the hell it is easy? We can very easily reduce this into that easy reduction way, which is that what you learn as g divided by 1 plus h g, right? So now to that, we are doing some sort of a change like this, right? So now this is what we are going to do. Unfortunately, originally we had the signal like this. Okay, so originally this is the position. So originally we had this signal. So now we are going to skip this signal to there, right? We are going to skip this signal to here. So now what is the difference? That is the logic. In case if we are going to shift this signal to here, then we are getting an unnecessary signal, which is G. But previously we don't have any G. So now we have G, it's G3 actually. So the signal that is ejected from here carrying this G3, right? So that is violating the original concept. So it's very easy. So let that G come. We will put another 1 over G3. Here G3 come in and we are putting 1 over G3. So to this G3 and this 1 over G3 both are getting cancelled. So it's very easy, right? So now we are going to further change this structure. Okay, so let R comes in the same format, R sum in operator positive. Guys, be very careful. In this reduction methods, we have to write the same thing again and again. So the tendency of making errors will be very high, right? Positive. Here G3, and I told you this signal is coming to there. Okay, so now what's the thing? You just put 1 over G3, right? So H3 divided by G3. This is H3 divided by G3. So now this is connected to here under the negative command. Okay, so now what are the rest of the signals here? This is C output. The rest of the signals will be H2 signal that is coming to here, negative, then H1 signal that is connected to here, negative. Okay, right. So now see, what is the next thing you can do? So now you have shifted this point to here. So now you can very easily do the reduction to here, right? So do the reduction to here. So now let's see how we can do that reduction. It will be very easy, right? So how can you reduce this? It's very easy. It will be, now it will be G3 divided by 1 plus G3 H3, okay? So the reason why plus, because here it's negative, okay? So now let's sketch it again. So here we have the signal R. I'll take this up, right? So if the signal R, can you see R? Yeah, signal R, then sum in operator positive, then G1 signal, and then again sum in operator positive, then G2 and positive, G1 positive, then G2, right? Then okay, so now after G2, now what we have, again look at here. Now here we can do the complete reduction. So now here what we have is G3 divided by 1 plus G3 H2. That's the thing we have. So then after that it is directed to this output C of S, right? Is everything is clear? Yeah, output C of S. And then what's the next thing? This H3 divided by G3. Okay, that is there. H3 divided by G3, that is there, right? There won't be any changes to that. That is connected to here under negative command. And what else? Okay, and we have this H1, the major signal, that is connected to here under the negative command. Okay, so now let's see, is everything clear? G J2 and this is going that, yeah, all clear. Okay, so now let's see what you can do. So now you can see here you can see a direct signal, right? Signal G2 and signal right after that, right? So if you can see two blocks in series, what you can do, it's very easy, right? You know the like basic rule, you already know. If you have signal like this, G1, okay, G2, what you can do? So rather than put into separate signals like this, you go to that electrical shop, whatever, just get a combined signal like this, or G1, G2, something like this. Easy, right? So the same thing you can apply to here. Okay, so I hope that is clear, right? So now again, now we can see R input, guys, this is R of S, okay? R summing operator, positive, and then G1, again summing operator, positive. So now you can do the like multiplication. So this summing operator definitely is there. Now you can put a large block, G2, G3 divided by 1 plus G3H2. Guys, I am like pronouncing one by one, so you can very easily hear. So now it sees the output. Still this H1 is there, which is connected as negative. Again, I am telling, be very careful when doing reduction, because as soon as you go to further steps, sometimes you might be forgetting the previous part. So careful. And what's next? Now again this particular signal is there. You can see this is connected H3 divided by G3, which is connected to here under negative. Okay, so now be very careful. So now look at here, right? So now see, this is also like a straight signal or something like a forward signal, right? So what is this? This part is like a reverse signal, or you can say feed back signal. Okay, very easy, right? So it is same as, now when you clearly observe this part, right, you can very clearly see it is also something like this. Now see, this is summing operator, positive, and then we have G, then the output. Usually we heard something like this, right? This is what usually we hear, right? Usually the reverse signal that is coming from downwards. But the same case is applied. You can even write this like in this way. Summing operator, forward signal G, then output Y. No problem. You can do the same thing. Like there is no position from where you are going to take it. You can even sketch it like this, right? So this is also same as this one. So that is why I'm telling, don't try to remember the things. Just study logical. So this part is also, right? Same block diagram reduction method. Also same as here. So now you can reduce this one also. But the thing is, do it carefully, okay? So now again, now I will remove this and I will sketch the ultimate one. R signal is coming in the positive. R signal is coming in the positive way. And then the block G1, okay? And now, so again, look this part. To this part, we are going to apply the reduction. Now, this is like, how to say, this is like that G. This is like that H. So, this is that negative symbol, or like that negative command, as in the previous way. So, now in this case, now after the reduction, you can just avoid or eliminate this summing operator. So, so we can completely avoid this unnecessary operator. Okay, so after G1, what will be getting? So So how you are going to reduce this? First, to the numerator, you are putting the forward signal. Here it is something like a fraction. To the numerator, you are putting the forward signal. So what is the forward signal over there? So this is the forward signal. G2 G3 divided by 1 plus G3 H2. No problem, that is the forward signal. To the numerator, 1 plus, why plus? Because that the feedback signal is negative, so 1 plus forward signal times the feedback signal. So what is the forward signal? It is G2 G3 divided by 1 plus G3 H2. Okay, right. And what is that reverse signal? H3 divided by G3. And you can further simplify this. Output will be C of S. And still we have that large feedback, which is H1. It is connected to here in negative, right? So now the important part is, so let's do the simplification to here. Now here you can see the common denominator. Here you can see the common denominator, right? Common denominator means 1 plus G3H2. So be very careful when doing the simplification. But the fact is, right? See guys, see again, 1 plus G2 G3 divided by 1 plus G3H2 times H3 divided by G3. It's okay now. This G3 you can cancel with this G3, so it's easy. So now here we have the common denominator, here also we have the common denominator. So now you can easily cut this one and this one, so this part will come to here. That is simple, that is simplification, right? So shall I sketch it here? Okay, doesn't matter. Okay, I'll sketch it here. So here we have input signal RS. Okay, then to the summing operator positive, then to this very like larger block. My god, I'm sweating. It's okay. Then let's put this larger block. I forgot this G1. This G1 is coming, right? Okay, I'll sketch it again. Then it's easy. So now what we are going to do is, we are just going to simplify this part, right? Nothing else. R summing operator positive, G1, then here told you the larger block, and then the output C of S, G2 G3 divided by 1 plus G3 H2, that divided by, after cancelling we have 1 plus G3 H2, so that is going there, 1 plus G3 H2 plus G2H3 divided by 1 plus G3H2. Okay, and we have this reverse signal H1, which is connected negative. I think that's it. So now you can cancel this one. Easy now, it's nothing. So now, after simplifying this, again you will be getting two forward or two series signals, right? Or the direct signals. So this result you can multiply with this one, right? It's easy, right? So at the same place, now we can write it like this: R positive, this larger block, CS, C of S. So now this result multiply with this one, G1, G2, G3 divided by 1 plus G3H2 plus G2H3. Okay, So still we have that feedback signal. Be careful, don't forget the symbols or don't forget the signals. So now what we can do? Easy, right? Took little time. So now this is like that same feedback type thing, right? The thing that I taught you very initially. See this format like thing. So now this is like the forward function. This is like the reverse function or the feedback function. So now you can very easily reduce this. Again, look at this. Right. So now we can go for the ultimate solution. Right. So. Right. So this is like capital G, the big G. This is like the reverse signal H. Easy. R, because I told you after reduction, after doing the reduction thing, you will not get another summing operator. This is C. Let's call it C of S. Okay, the first thing is, what do you have to put in the numerator? The forward function, g1, g2, g3 divided by 1 plus g3 h2 plus g2 h3, right? g2 h3 divided by 1 plus, why 1 plus? Because the reason, here the reverse or the feedback signal is negative. Right, so 1 plus forward signal times the feedback signal. So what is the feedback signal? It is H1. Okay, right. So what is the feedback signal? That is H1. What is the signal you have here? G1, G2, G3 divided by 1 plus G3 H2 plus G2 H3. Right, so that's it. So now again you can go for some further simplifications, right? Then this will look nice. C of S. Now here this part is like the common denominator, so you can just cancel this one with this one after multiplying this with this, but doesn't matter, I will write it, otherwise you will get a like a wrong idea. Multiply this with this one, 1 plus g3 h2 plus g2 h3, okay, plus this part, the part that you have it here, g1 g2 g3 h1, and still you have the common denominator, 1 plus g3 h2 plus g2 h3, and to the top part, g1 g2 g3 divided by 1 plus g3 h2 plus g2 h3. You can cancel this one with this one. So now it's very easy. So now let's go for the ultimate signal. It's easy. Right? So we have R. So now what is there? G1, G2, G3. G1, G2, G3 divided by 1 plus G3 H2, 1 plus G3 H2 plus G2 H3 plus G2 H3, then G1 2 3 H1 plus G1 G2 G3 H1, then this output C. So that means this input signal you are going to multiply with this block equals this C. So that means R times this large signal जी वन जी टू जी थ्री डिवाइडेड बाय वन प्लस जी थ्री एच टू प्लस जी टू एच थ्री प्लस जी वन जी टू जी थ्री एच वन इक्वल्स वॉट सी. सो नाउ यू कैन से पुट दिस आर टू द डिनोमिनेटर ऑन द अदर साइड. सो सी डिवाइडेड बाय आर इक्वल्स टू जी वन जी टू जी थ्री डिवाइडेड बाय वन प्लस जी थ्री एच टू प्लस जी टू एच थ्री प्लस जी वन जी टू जी थ्री एच वन. इज इजी, इट्स नथिंग. ओके गाइस, थैंक यू.